I guarantee you that out of the five things I'm about to share with you, some of them are kind of weird. Out of the five things I share, one or two of them will completely change the way you go about creating your dream life, understanding how to bridge those realities. And they're techniques that I actually used to create my own dream life, which includes getting to live in a really cool house, which I love living in. It'll look like I'm trying to flex right now. That's what it's gonna look like no matter what I do. But the truth is, I went from working a 9-to-5 job that I did not enjoy to living my dream life, doing what I love, traveling the world, working from online, getting to, you know, live in I guess what I consider to be my dream house. And I'm excited to share exactly step by step what I did, some of the weird techniques I used to manifest my dream life easier than ever. And in this video, there is five of them. So I promise, stick to the end of the video, watch these five, apply at least one or two of them in your life, and I promise you, your life will change. Manifestation can also be easier than ever when you allow it to be. It's about understanding your identity. It's about embodying that version of you. What I did is I bridged my reality of being that 9-to-5 job person to then just being a YouTuber, making videos, trusting that vision, and my life eventually began to change. So I'm gonna go ahead and let's go ahead and get into the five things right now. Now, one of the first things I do is I have this ritual thing that I do while laying in bed every single morning right when I wake up. Now, here's a funny little story, not funny, but it's one story that I may have shared before, but when I actually wanted this house, so right now I'm in the master bedroom at the house that I live in. And when I wanted this house originally, I was living at this place called Palms Place, which is like these condos here in Las Vegas. I was here because I went 3 months traveling and then decided to stay there while I found the place that I wanted to rent for the next year. And I looked at many different houses. None of them really stood out to me that much. Then I found this house, and when I found this house, I knew immediately that I wanted it. I came, I saw the house. There was a guy that was still had like a month or two left. For some reason, they put the house on the like to be rented like a month before it was even available, like 2 months before it was even available. But I saw it and I knew I wanted it. I was like, man, I gotta live at this Palms Place for a little bit longer. I didn't really like it that much because it was nice, but it was like so close to so many other people and stuff like that. Well, what I eventually did is I saw this house. And then what I did is I knew the layout and I knew that this is what the room looked like. So what I did is I imagined my furniture, I imagined me being here, and every morning I would wake up, even at that Palms Place place, what I did is I imagined me laying in that bed there, I imagined me laying here and what it would feel like to wake up to have this house that I really enjoy being in, to be able to create videos, to be able to do what I wanna do. So. They say that going to the bed, this is a Neville Goddard concept. Neville Goddard was like an old school teacher of this kind of information back in like the early 1900s, I believe. And basically it's called feeling is the secret. So as you go to bed or as you wake up in the morning, you put your hand over your heart. And what you do is you imagine what it would feel like to be in that reality. And as you invoke the feeling, and as you see yourself there, you are influencing your subconscious mind to believe that that's your reality. And what I did is I did that for at least, I think, a week. And then after about a week, 7 or 8 days, I got a call from the guy that lived in the house. And he said, you know what? He knew that I kind of wanted to get in earlier. He rearranged some things around and he was out within that week. Moved out completely and I was able to move in even though it was supposed to be another week, it was supposed to be another month or two until he was out. So by me being in that state, feeling that emotion and doing that right when I was going to bed at night and then right when I wake up in the morning, that influenced my subconscious mind and changed my reality. And the reason you do it right before you go to bed or right when you wake up is as you are drifting off to sleep, you are going from deep levels of, you're going from more awake states like beta and alpha into theta, delta. As you drift off into those deeper states, you then have influence over your subconscious mind. When you wake up in the morning, you're going from a theta to an alpha to a beta state. So you have this the longer you can soak in that theta state and see yourself as that version of you, the more powerful it is. So even this morning as I woke up, I thought of some of the things I wanted to create in my life. I felt as if I was already there. I saw myself. This is another key thing. See yourself as that version of you. Literally wake up and believe that that is who you are. And as you invoke that feeling, as you invoke that emotion and you be present in it, you'll find that then it changes your reality in very powerful ways. So that's the first way to go about it. Super powerful. Commit to this for the next 21 days. I also have a meditation, a free meditation that you can use that explains this exact process. You just listen to it every single night as you're about to fall asleep. And it's going to be in the top of the description box below. It's a manifest while you sleep meditation. Anyways, let's go into the next one, right?
Meow.
Now, the second kind of weird thing that I did to change and to create my dream life has to actually do with something that's in my closet right now. Now, you'll see in my closet, it's just clothes and stuff like that. One thing I did to let go of my old identity, because realize that your life and the way you're showing up in the world is based on who you think you are, your identity, the way you view yourself. And if you view yourself as only able to make, like, you know, $20,000 a year, then you will constantly take action, you will constantly embody that identity, that version of you. And because you view yourself that way, you're not gonna attract opportunities of you making more than that, because you have what is called a cybernetic mechanism, which is like a something that reverts back to the baseline. So if your baseline is I make 20K a year, and then you start to make 30K a year, you may sabotage yourself to bring you back down to what you're comfortable with. So one of the things that I did, it might sound kind of weird, but there was like an old version of me that I had. What I did is I actually took some of those clothes and I literally gave them away. I gave them away to other people because, or I donated, I think I donated a lot of them to this thing in Vegas. But what that did is I let go of the way I viewed the past older self of me that was of a certain identity. I realized I was working that 9-to-5 job I didn't like. You know, think about it like this too. This might sound kind of weird, esoteric. Everything is energy. And even the clothes that we wear, there's a certain energy. And if we wear certain clothes consistently, what happens is our energy goes into the clothes. But imagine you wear clothes of when you were going through depression. Imagine you wear clothes of when you were going and you were really sad, you know, unless you energetically clear. And I know it sounds kind of weird, but there was this experience that I had where there was this one sweater, and when I would wear it, there was a point when I wore it with one of my ex-girlfriends or something like that. And then when I stopped wearing that sweater, I then wore it like 2 or 3 like years later. And I was just thinking about them and I couldn't figure out why. Well, I realized that when I was going through some like rough stuff with that person, I was wearing that sweater. And that's when I started to learn more about the esoteric nature of energy. But getting rid and letting go of some of the clothes you have that kind of reinforce your old identity could be a very powerful thing to do. Now, I know it's not practical for everybody because it costs money to buy new clothes, but if you've been wearing the same clothes for many years and there's a certain identity, certain way you view in yourself, even getting and having a new style can help make you see yourself differently. If you were to buy more, like I have a lot of like this athletic type clothes and stuff like that, by wearing certain clothes, it can wire in a certain sense of identity. And as you wire that in, it becomes more natural for you to be in that. So maybe you find yourself more active if you start wearing more active clothes. If you dress up nicer, maybe you start to feel more confident about yourself. They have shown that that does affect confidence as well. So I know this is kind of one of those esoteric things, but letting go of clothes that no longer serves, donating some clothes that kind of reinforce your old identity could be a very powerful way of letting go of that past self to then wire in the way you prefer to be, which is you wearing what you want. It doesn't have to be expensive or anything, but it's you like giving yourself permission to wire in, to let go of the old identity and wire in the new. So now let's move on to number 3. This one may sound a little bit weird as well, but it also has to do with attracting this house, which I knew had to be equal to the identity that I had. But one thing that I realized I was doing is, I'm not trying to brag by showing it to you, I just figured I'd come outside to change up the scenery. but one thing that I did is I had to view myself. I realized that when I really wanted this house, one thing that I was doing is I was putting this house on a pedestal. So what I was doing is I was like, man, it would be so awesome to be in this house, and like, it's just perfect. There's this perfect layout. It's so open floors. It's like everything that I would want. And because I was putting it so much on a pedestal, what ended up happening is I could see that I was creating resistance. Now, anything you create, put on a pedestal, you create resistance around, which then blocks it from coming into your life. So one thing that I did to switch this around is I imagined that the house itself, it's gonna sound kind of weird, the house itself has a consciousness and wants me to be here. I did this with my last house as well. Maybe you remember the last house where it was like the kitchen was right in the background, it was a real open floor plan as well. And I filmed a lot of videos there. And it was the same thing. When I really wanted that house, I was in competition, it guys, competition in a way, with many other people that applied for that house. But one thing I did is I imagined that the house wanted me to be there. I also, what I did is I wrote a letter to the people that own the house and said, hey, it's a beautiful home. I'd really like to live there. I work from home. So, you know, I also, this is what you call outer intention. Outer intention is, you normally have your own intention, like I want this. Now, what happens is when you say, I want this, what you're doing is that's your own internal intention. If you tap into someone else's intention, which their intention is to have someone rent the house that was very clean and you know, takes good care of the house, that really appreciates the house. So by me thinking of the value it would provide to them, that then like has a different type of energy dynamic. Now, in the same way with this house, I imagined that kind of energy, what I'd be able to create in this house, the kind of videos that I could make that would help a lot of people in the world. Because we live in a reality where we're all connected, when you tap into adding value to other people, or even as esoteric as it sounds, other things, like I imagine the house and even the trees wanted me to be here because of how much I would appreciate them. I know it sounds kind of weird, but I hug the trees every night. Not all of them, just a couple. Couple of my favorites. I always wonder, do trees get jealous? If you're hugging one of them and then the other one next to it, like this is the tree that I hug every day. Okay, you can kind of see it. It's that one right over there. I can't really see if it's, anyways, that one right there. And then that one right there, I think it's kind of jealous because then I got to walk on rocks to hug it. I don't know. I know it sounds kind of weird, but yeah. Anyways, if a weird way to manifest what you want. So realize whatever you want in your life also wants you. See, that switches the energy dynamic around. You want to attract a person to your life. What if you realize there's someone else out there that wants you, trying to attract you? Then it's you realize your own value. Then you feel kind of, you feel like you filled up your own cup. So instead of trying to chase anything, because chasing implies something is running, instead of putting something on a pedestal, because when you put it on a pedestal, you vibrationally separate yourself from it. No, you're good either way. You're already whole and complete. And as you fill up your own cup and you realize that these things also want you because of the value you can provide, that's when the energy dynamic really begins to change. So that's the third thing that I did, a way you guys can all apply this in your life, is see how what you do can add value. You know, a lot of people want to like manifest money. They want to manifest a cool lifestyle. They want to manifest a person. But are you creating the opportunity for those things to come into your life by providing value out into the world? Because the way our reality works is the more value you put out, the more energy you put out, the more energy you get back. Some people are like, I want to manifest this. Well, are you of the identity? Are you embodying that version of you? Are you an artist that's creating amazing art that is like art that's adding value and making people feel a certain emotion? Are you focused on that art? Are you creating art every day? Then you're setting yourself up for these things to come back at you. Start to see yourself as an amazing artist, which is the identity. I started to see myself as a YouTuber making daily videos and adding value to people. And I wired that identity with daily videos. And then eventually that became my reality. And I get to travel the world doing what I love and live in a nice house, you know? Any of you can do that. But you have to make a new choice about who you are. And you have to realize you don't have to chase any of it. You chase it means you're not of, and it's not equal to your identity. So that's the third thing. Now the fourth thing is this. The fourth thing that's changed my life more than anything else, I would say, is bridging the identity. So let me show you something real quick. So imagine that this is the old version of you, and then that's the new version of you. Now what you want to do is unwire the old version of you and wire in the new version of you. Now one thing that I did is I realized that the old version of me was that of working a 9-to-5 job I did not like, going to work every day, complaining about having to go to work and sell women's shoes. You know, I had to wear a suit to work, which I guess wasn't the end of the world, but I didn't necessarily enjoy doing it. That was my reality. I worked 40 hours a week there. And then what happened is I eventually realized and that what I wanted to do is to be the identity of creating a YouTube, like being a YouTuber. And to that, what that meant to me was making a video every single day. I knew that if I made a video every single day, it would change my life more than anything else, because then I was, if you want to go full-time doing what you love, you have to do what you love full-time, energy-wise, before it's even your full-time. So I was working 40 hours a week at that 9-to-5 job, plus I was making videos 30 hours a week. I was letting that become my dominant vibration, and because I was so passionate about it, it ended up developing momentum. So the thing that I encourage you to do is to create your dream life, find the thing you're the most passionate about, figure, learn different aspects of it. I had to learn how to market my ideas. I had to learn how to make thumbnails. I had to learn how to edit. I had to learn how to do all these things I didn't know before, but guess what? It eventually went into the larger picture of me gaining momentum on my YouTube channel to where then I could get the freedom to quit that 9-to-5 job months later. So if you embody that energy, if you embody that vibration, trusting it 100%, and are focused on, once again, like the other thing of adding value to others, it is super powerful. And what I did is even since then, you know, I was making daily videos for 3 years in a row. I'd have this camera set up in the morning, this little ring, Diva ring light for like makeup artists and stuff. And then what I did is I have this and my board, and I've been making videos for such a long time. And every morning is set up for me to do that. And even now, as it's already my lifestyle, I wire it in like 3-4 days a week instead of every day, because now I'm focused on some other things too. But that daily work, that identity of wiring it every single day has been key. So if you're an artist, leave your easel up every day and paint every day. Doesn't mean you have to paint a whole painting every day, but paint every day. Get in the action and the vibration of what you want every single day, and it won't seem like big change over a week, but imagine doing that for like 2 or 3 months. You know, every day it compounds. Every day it compounds until it gains so much momentum that eventually you can let go completely of the old identity, which is when I quit that 9-to-5 job, put my 2 weeks in. My last day was the Conor McGregor. I can never say it. Conor McGregor and Mayweather, it's weird to say together. That fight was the last day of my 9-to-5 job back in 2017. I went, watched the fight. I worked early that morning because I knew it would be a lot of money to be made commission-wise. Then I went to a friend's house, we watched the fight, and that was the last day I ever had a 9-to-5 job. Then I was able to let it go. But in order to let it go, you have to also wire in that new version of you every single day. With that being said, let's move into number 5, right? Meow. Welcome to number 5. Honestly, this isn't gonna sound that weird, but I would say that, you know, this right here, let me show you. This is the room that I was in for number 1, showing you guys like my room and stuff. This right here is my little section where I meditate every day. Now, the kind of meditation I do is I stare at a candle flame. And when I stare at a candle flame, that quiets down my thoughts, that allows me to be more present. But what I focus on is I focus on gratitude. I focus on what I'm grateful for. I focus on the things that I already have in my life that I'm grateful for. Even when I had that 9-to-5 job, I was grateful for my family, my friends. I was grateful for the spiritual books that I could read and all these other things. And by focusing on what I'm grateful for, it unifies you with the high vibrational energy. And then what happens is it makes it easier for you to imagine the things you want to create in your life. And it's like those things are in that state, it's even more powerful. So think about it in terms of alignment. When you're focused on gratitude, it easily aligns you to a higher vibration. And then as you focus on what you already have, then you focus on the things you want to bring into your life. And it's almost like your mind doesn't know the difference. So one thing I would do is I would imagine, you know, me having the freedom to travel the world, do what I love. Me having a nice camera to create equipment with, like some things I already had, but then some things that I wanted to create in my life. And one of the first goals I had was like, you know, the YouTube plaque for 100,000. That was like my first one big goal that I had. So I'd focus on that, and I feel like I already had it. And over the course of a period of time, that eventually obviously came into my life. So the thing that I encourage you to do is to meditate every single day, observe your thoughts, stare at a candle flame. As simple as that sounds, that can quiet your mind. When your eyes don't wander, your mind doesn't wander. And what you'll find is that then, because you've neutralized resistance and you focused on gratitude, your vibration is higher to actually create what you want. Like I said, that meditation in the beginning for manifesting while you sleep is probably one of the most powerful meditations I have. I challenge you to 21 days of listening to that meditation, manifesting, thinking about what you want to create in your life, feeling the emotions of it. Listen to it for 21 days. Watch how much it changes your life. Leave comments below as you go through that 21-day challenge. Let's make this a group thing. I'm super excited to do that with you. If you haven't already, subscribe. Also, like this video if you liked it as well. Appreciate that. And as always, I'll see you on the next video. Peace, much love, and namaste.